This tiny teach is going to cover the gram stain. Before I talk about the gram stain, I want to review the cell envelope of gram positive and gram negative bacteria, because the cell envelope plays a critical role in how the gram stain procedure works. So first let's review the cell envelope of gram positive bacteria. Gram positive bacteria have two parts to their cell envelope. They have a cell wall that's a thick layer of peptidoglycan, and they have a cell membrane that lies underneath. Let's compare this with the cell envelope of gram-negative bacteria. Gram-negative bacteria have three layers to their cell envelope. They have an outer membrane made of LPS. Underneath that, a cell wall that's made of a thin layer of peptidoglycan. And underneath that, a cell membrane. Now on to the gram stain itself. The gram stain is an example of a differential stain. It's going to divide bacteria into two groups. Gram-positive bacteria will be purple at the end of the gram stain. Gram-negative bacteria will be pink at the end of the gram stain. You're going to always begin the gram stain with a smear that's been heat fixed, and then you're going to start your procedure. Bacteria are all colorless. They have no color to them, and they have an overall negative charge. This is very important information for us to know before we get started with the actual gram stain. The first step in the gram stain is to add the primary stain, crystal violet. Crystal violet is purple in color, and it's a positively charged dye. So we're going to add crystal violet to the smear, wait 1 minute, and then rinse it off with deionized water. All bacteria at the end of the first step are going to be purple. Gram-positive bacteria are purple, and gram-negative bacteria are purple. That's because all bacteria have an overall negative charge, and so they're all attracted to the positively charged crystal violet. The second step in the gram stain is to add Lugol's iodine to the smear and wait 1 minute. Lugol's iodine is not going to change the color of the bacteria. Actually, what the iodine is going to do is it's going to bind to the crystal violet that's already attached to the bacteria. So we're going to form crystal violet iodine complexes that are very large, and they can get trapped in peptidoglycan. So at the end of the second step in the gram stain, when we use iodine, gram-positive bacteria are still purple and gram-negative bacteria are still purple. The third step in the gram stain is to decolorize. You can use acetone alcohol like we do in lab, or you can just use alcohol. You're going to add your decolorizer to your smear, and you're just going to wait a few seconds until the color lifts, and then you're going to rinse it off with deionized water. After the decolorizing step, your gram-positive bacteria are still going to be purple. They're going to have retained the crystal violet or the primary stain because they have that thick layer of peptidoglycan, and the crystal violet iodine complexes are trapped in that thick layer of peptidoglycan. The decolorizer dehydrates the bacteria a little bit, which actually sort of squeezes in that peptidoglycan and really traps those crystal violet iodine complexes in that thick layer of peptidoglycan that gram-positive bacteria have. In gram-negative bacteria, at the end of the decolorization step, they're back to colorless. They're back where they started at the beginning. That's because the decolorizer breaks apart the outer membrane in gram-negative bacteria, and the thin layer of peptidoglycan underneath cannot retain the crystal violet iodine complexes. So the decolorizer breaks apart the outer membrane of gram-negative bacteria, and the crystal violet iodine complexes are released from the thin layer of peptidoglycan that lies underneath that broken apart outer membrane. The final step in the gram stain is to add safranin, also a positively charged dye, to the smear, wait 1 minute, and rinse with deionized water. The reason we have to do the secondary or counter stain of safranin is that our gram-negative bacteria are colorless and we won't be able to see them. So when we add the secondary or counter stain that is safranin, which has a positive charge, it won't change the color of gram-positive bacteria. They already were attracted to the positively charged crystal violet, so they're going to stay purple. But our gram-negative bacteria, which were colorless, they'll be attracted, since gram-negative bacteria, like all bacteria, have an overall negative charge. They'll be attracted to the positively charged safranin, and they will end up pink in color. So at the end of the gram stain, gram-positive bacteria are purple, gram-negative bacteria are pink. Gram-positive and gram-negative don't have anything to do with the charge of bacteria. Be careful, all bacteria have a negative charge. Gram-positive and gram-negative are telling you what grouping do the bacteria go into. Are they gram-positive bacteria? They have a cell envelope that's made of a thick layer of peptidoglycan wall and an underlying cell membrane, and they're purple at the end of the gram stain. Or are they gram-negative bacteria? They're pink at the end of the gram stain. Their cell envelope has an outer membrane, a thin layer of peptidoglycan that is the wall underneath that, and a cell membrane. It's really important to think about what's happening at each step, why the two groups of bacteria, gram-positive and gram-negative, are the color that they are at each step, and why that happened.